Royal Navy to receive minesweepers. The Royal Navy is set to receive 3 world-class autonomous minesweepers to work on mine disposal operations and reduce the risk to sailors on these dangerous missions. The crewless system is the first of its kind in the Navy and will allow personnel to neutralize mines at range while on operations around the globe. Thanks to its cutting-edge technology, the system, known as a combined influence sweep, can defeat modern digital sea mines which can pose risks by detecting and targeting passing ships and submarines. A new autonomous vessel is at the heart of each of the 3 systems. It can neutralize many types of sea mines using equipment towed behind the boat that can generate a variety of simulated magnetic, acoustic and electric ship signatures to initiate the mine. The whole system can be controlled remotely, either based at sea or on land, and can be deployed quickly when needed. A contract of around £25 million has been awarded to Atlas Electronic UK to deliver the sweep system and will support more than 25 jobs at the Dorset-based company. Additional jobs will also be supported in the supply chain. These autonomous systems will restore the Royal Navy's sweep capability, enabling it to tackle modern digital mines that may not otherwise be located in challenging mine hunting conditions. Commander Mark Atkinson. Commander Mark Atkinson, part of the project team for the Royal Navy, said, "Combined influence mine sweeping is a critical component of the mine countermeasures capability. These autonomous systems will restore the Royal Navy's sweep capability, enabling it to tackle modern digital mines that may not otherwise be located in challenging mine hunting conditions. The autonomous sweep system represents a fundamental step in the Navy's transition to autonomous offboard systems to counter the threat posed to international shipping by the sea mine. The latest investment in the Royal Navy's mine hunting operations comes just weeks after the Navy announced it would be investing in 3 autonomous maritime mine countermeasures, MMCM, systems. Both SWEEP and the MMCM can work together to defeat the threat posed by sea mines to make international waters safer. The first SWEEP system will be delivered in late 2022. After which they will enter operational evaluation before entering service at a date to be determined." Sir Simon Bolam, D&S Chief Executive, said, "This cutting-edge sweep technology follows hot on the heels of the contract negotiated for equally innovative autonomous mine hunters and provides the Royal Navy with the increased capability they need to deal with modern mine threats." Boomer UFs make BPV. Drones could play a key role in tracking drug runners and smugglers after successful trials with the Navy's newest class of ships in the Channel. HMS Tamar made extensive use of small Puma aircraft during trials with the Royal Marines and the Met Police as the ship practices for constabulary duties when she deploys for the first time this summer. Although Tamar has a flight deck, she doesn't carry a helicopter on a regular basis. There's no hangar, so Merlin and Wildcat helicopters only use the ship for refueling, collecting supplies or making a short stop. The Puma could fulfill some of the helicopter's intelligence gathering role, with its 50x zoom camera it feeds live footage back to a mother ship at ranges up to a dozen miles. Building on their experiences aboard HMS Albion in the Mediterranean last year, a team from 700X Naval Air Squadron, the Fleet Air Arm's only pilotless squadron, brought their drone to Tamar. Just over 4.5 feet long, with a wingspan of 9 feet and weighing as much as 6 bags of sugar, Puma can survey an area of up to 270 square miles of ocean, that's larger than Greater Manchester, looking for suspicious activity during sorties lasting up to 2.5 hours. "We were under pressure to perform. There are many additional challenges in preparing and launching safely from a ship. While it's a relatively small aircraft, it has a large wing and requires some skill from the operator launching it from the ship. We completed 100% of the tasks required of us by the ship. We were often flying out of line of sight to approach vessels, using the system's cameras for identification purposes. We'd be in close communications with the officer of the watch and we were able to report back successfully on the identification of vessels. Lieutenant Ash Loftus, Puma Flight Commander. Puma is relatively cheap, certainly much cheaper than sending a helicopter up, easy to launch and recover, is difficult for foes to spot and keeps the ship out of harm's way. In short, Puma gave Tamar eyes in the sky. It was of great use for investigating nearby vessels of interest. We could easily see just how useful such a system could be for any future anti-piracy or counter-smuggling operations. It's a significant enhancement of the ship's capabilities and bodes well for the future. Lieutenant Commander Michael Hutchinson. Tamar and her four sisters are being deployed around the world on long-term missions, operating from overseas ports and bases, patrolling regions of key strategic interest and importance to the UK. Constabulary duties, counter-piracy/terrorism/smuggling, are a key role of the new River-class ships. Typically the vessels will work with Royal Marines boarding teams, a 50-man mess has been built into the ships to accommodate them. But there may be occasions when Tamar may be called on to work with local law enforcement agencies, such as her sister HMS Medway has been doing in the Caribbean, striking at drug runners with the US Coast Guard. The combined training with the Metropolitan Police in the Channel proved extremely useful for both the Navy and UK's largest police force. The Met used Tamar as their floating headquarters, turning her into a command and control vessel to marshal their RIB speedboats. The latter are used to the sheltered waters of the Thames, their normal domain ends at Dartford Creek, and found operating in the choppy channel rather difficult. Working with the police proved to be a new experience for all parties concerned. The main fruit was a much greater understanding of each other's capabilities and how to most effectively make use of these depending on the operational context, Lieutenant Commander Hutchinson added. Tamar is now concentrating on preparing ship and ship's company for her maiden overseas deployment, earmarked for this summer.